Hey everybody, thanks for being here. Today we're hover fishing with Ro in the Klickitat River and in the Columbia River at the mouth of the Klickitat. Now if you want to learn how to catch more fish, stay tuned. I'm Justin Wolf and this is Angler West Television. The Columbia River has been on fire this year for salmon, and in some areas, hover fishing Ro is extremely effective and well practiced by Jason Handley, Stephen Jason Lynch, and George Crum.
We've been out here, we spent about a week up here at fish camp, did excellent every day. We get 12 to 15 fish in a whack, so we're expecting to do pretty good today.
So what we're going to do is we're going to start out the morning up in the Klickitat, and then as the day progresses, we're probably going to head out into the main river, fish the Columbia right at the mouth of the Klickitat River.
So we're going to be hover fishing using eggs, and these were cured with our liquid egg cure, the red hot double stuff. We soaked them about 12 hours, then air dried them for about 4 hours. And they're just right straight out of the cure, and these have been working just the way they are. Maybe a little Salmon powder on them, but for the most part, just straight out of the cure.
We just entered out of the Columbia River into the mouth of the Klickitat. Up here in the Klickitat, they get a pretty significant run of Chinook and silvers. We're in the kind of right in the gut of the Chinook run, so there should be a whole pile of fish up in here.
Can you hand me a pair of those gloves?
Fishing with eggs a lot. I like to run gloves just because it keeps the scent off your bait, and also it keeps your hands from getting hammered by all the chemicals. So it's definitely a wise investment.
The hooks up here in the Washington tributaries as well as the Columbia have to be barbless hooks, so you want to make sure you pinch the barb down on them. And that is all we're running is a combination of eggs and shrimp. The eggs here, we are running the liquid egg here with a little bit of sodium sulfite and a dash of monster bite in them. It seems to work out really well. Sand shrimp. Just break a little piece of the tail off and put on the hook. Just like so.
Nice. That didn't take long.
Yeah.
Jason, I just put a drop of anise oil on those.
Well, perfect. We'll pass it off.
Nicely done, George, thank you. This is a Klickitat River Chinook right here. This is about average size for them. And you see the thing just swallowed these eggs.
The Chinook Steve got was on our first pass here this morning, and it's probably a little below average size there. But the fishing in the river is really good first thing in the morning, just because the Klickitat River is a glacial-fed river, so it stays a little cooler in temperature, and the visibility right now is actually very good. Sometimes on the hotter days, it'll silt up quite bad, but we should be able to pick up a few out here before we head out into the Columbia. Usually fishing in here is pretty darn good.
The important thing with the rods up here, we're looking for a shorter rod because you've got to point it at the water. So you want a stiff butt section, but you have a soft enough tip where you can just barely feel the bite. And all we're doing is dropping down, hitting bottom, and bringing it up three cranks. So, you know, every 3 or 4 minutes, you're hitting the release and refining bottom and readjusting your depth. Yep. Good boy, George. I guess I'll reel up and net your fish.
Well, that was mighty kind of you.
That's a little better fish.
Ranges.
Yep.
Hey, that hook came out right when it hit the net.
Now that fish is a little bit brighter than the last one. Not a bad fish.
Hey, I hope you're enjoying today's episode where we're hover fishing with Roe for salmon. Now the rod that we're using is the Lamaglass Redline 7'10". The model number is HS710MC. Now this rod is perfect for this type of fishing for several reasons. It's 7'10", so it's not too long. If it was any longer, you'd have a hard time holding the rod at the right angle, so your tip is just a foot or so off the water, like it needs to be. If it was any shorter, you'd lose some of that parabolic action that's gonna help you fight the fish successfully. And the red line is a great price. These are some awesome rods you should take a look at. Now, if you wanna step up to the best, the Lamaglass SI series. These are the ultimate rods for lots of different applications. Now this 7'10" model is designed specifically for hover fishing. That's really an awesome rod. If a salmon gets anywhere near your bait, if it breathes on your bait, you're gonna know it because this rod is that sensitive. Now, let's go back and catch some more salmon.
We're near the mouth of the Klickitat River, which hits the Columbia a few miles downstream and across from Hood River, Oregon. We're hover fishing Roe tipped with sand shrimp, which is all about keeping your bait in the strike zone.
Check bottom again, guys. This gets real deep through here. Fish right through here. This is about the deepest part of the hole, and fish seem to hold closer to the bottom. And so generally what we do is we drop down all the way to the bottom and reel up two or three cranks, and then once we're down there, we're in the strike zone.
I'll keep this in my pocket. Keep it liquefied. Real anise will freeze up on you in the colder weathers. It just turns like a dried ice. But the beauty is you put it in your pocket for about 5 minutes and it'll liquefy right back up. I just missed one. I was daydreaming.
You need a bite like the one I had. You could have been asleep and caught that one. It just pulled the rod down.
Up here, it's a lot of times, more times than not, it's just a one-tap bite. And if you're not there ready to set it, they're gone. As soon as they feel their weight, they just suck your eggs off and they're gone. So it's amazing that a 10 to 20 pound fish can come up and get your bait off without you even knowing it.
Generally, you want your rod tip to be about a foot to 2 feet off the water line. The reason you do that is because the less movement you have on that rod tip, the less you're disturbing your bait down there, number one. Number two, when your rod's a little lower like that, you're able to have a little more room for a good solid hook set.
Way to go, James.
Going toward you, Dad.
This one looks like a little bigger fish.
That one's a little larger size Chinook. This is probably closer to what's typical, maybe even a little bit bigger than average, but it's a beauty fish, and hopefully we got many more to come.
And then he's gone.
The crowds are starting to set in up here, so we're going to head down and try one other bucket, and then we're going to head out towards the out into the Columbia River.
So I just put a little bloody tuna on my eggs. That's what I hooked my last two fish on.
I'm putting a little bit of slamola on mine. This bait's been in for about, well, I don't know, 3 or 4 minutes. We're moving to another spot. I don't want to waste a bait, so I'm putting just a little bit of this on to kind of recharge it. The this is a garlic version.
Okay, so George put the Slamola on his bait, and what this is about 80% fine firming salts, and there's bite stimulants in here. This is the garlic. We have it two ways. We have it regular with no scent, and this has the garlic powder in added with it. But ideally, this will just help firm your baits up. So if you're wrapping quick fish with strip baits, this is a great way to firm your baits up. It'll tighten your eggs up. So just a little bit of this will go a long ways.
First drop in took about 2 minutes and we hooked up.
2 seconds. So,
yeah, 2 seconds.
I wasn't even on bottom yet.
Oh, can't win them all.
You lose it?
Yeah, right at the boat.
Okay, so we're using a 4-aught barbless Gatsu hook here, and we're using a 20-pound P-line fluorocarbon leader. This still has a barb on it, so I've got to pinch the barb. The fishing leader board is a great way to store all your leaders. It's got the slot, so you can wrap them all up. We pretty well abused this one this week. This was full about 3 days ago, so tonight we'll be tying a bunch more leaders and wrap them up on here. So I'm looking for a leader for my hand right about my armpit, roughly 30 inches, 31 inches, right in there.
So we've been up in the Klickitat River here for about an hour or so. I think we've picked up 5 fish, and now we're going to head out into the Columbia River and see what we can do out there.
We've done well hover fishing with Roe in the Klickitat River first thing this morning, and now we're heading just outside the mouth of the Klickitat to the Columbia River, where we can intercept fish heading to the Klickitat or others heading further upstream.
Now we're out here in the Columbia River, and we're going to be following right along the 30-foot mark at first, and then once it starts to trickle down, we'll probably shift out to 55 feet and just work our way down. And again, 3 cranks off the bottom.
I just hooked a sturgeon. I just got too close to the bottom, I think. Yeah. The reel just blew up.
The sturgeon?
Yeah. It's going out in the middle, buddy.
Watch the rod, dude. Just break it off. So Steve just hooked an oversized sturgeon, and best thing to do in this case is just break them off, because otherwise you're going to be chasing it through about 20 lines and you're going to have a big time mess.
Good on that.
Oh, just came off again. Lost another one.
Today, huh? At least mine are coming in the boat. 2 for me. How many you got, Jason? Oh, that's right, none. That fish totally just swallowed this bait. This is with a liquid egg cure, and I just made it a little hotter with sodium sulfite. And my 2 fish that I've got with these have just been swallowed all the way down. The beauty of barbless hook, so it comes right out. Nice fish.
We hooked a couple fish in tight. Now we're going to head out a little bit deeper into 55 feet of water and see what we can turn up here. Seems to be usually a pretty productive line, so.
Double, double. We're getting real up there, yeah.
This is why we bring 2 nets. We get doubles. So.
It's
not
happening.
Watch the motor.
job.
Yeah.
Woohoo. Okay, we just doubled up right here. This is my third fish, so I'm done for the day. But it's kind of why you bring two nets. Get two fish on at a time, you can get them both in.
When we're out here fishing at this time of year, the water temperature is running about 65 degrees, and a lot of times you'll see people out here hanging their fish over the side. The water being 65 degrees is not the best thing for the fish, so your best bet is to get a kill bag, and in that kill bag just keep some ice, and that way you can keep the fish on ice and keep them nice and cooled down and keep the meat preserved a lot better. So.
Dinner, James.
Nice.
Cool. Way to go, George. Here's another one that took that swallowed the baits all the way down.
It's going to turn on here.
Well, after a very good morning bite, things have kind of slowed up a little bit, and finally James hooked into one, and hopefully everything will turn back on.
Before we go back to the river, I want to show you exactly how the eggs or the roe was prepared or cured for today's fishing. Now, it was a very simple process, especially since ProCure has come up with this ProCure liquid egg cure, which makes everything so simple. And this is how those eggs that you're seeing used in the show today were prepared. It's very simple. I've butterflied a couple skeins of eggs, the eggs out of one fish, put them in a bag. This is, first, very important, shake it up. And all you're going to do is cover your eggs with the cure. You want to make sure that you've got good fresh eggs, that the blood has been removed. And that's just a matter of cutting the fish when they're caught and make sure you've got good blood-free eggs. Squeeze the air out of them a little bit. And that's just almost enough. I'm going to put just a little bit more in there and make sure that we've got plenty and it's good and covered. Now, I want to use these eggs for fish that are upriver, away from the ocean, just like the Klickitat River or in that part of the Columbia River. So the secret there is to use sodium sulfite, and this makes it hotter. This makes it something that the fish really want to bite for some reason, and I don't exactly know why it works, but it does work. So we're going to take just a half a teaspoon of sodium sulfite, not more, because you don't want to make your eggs too hot. You're going to sprinkle that in there, close it up, and roll that around. Now you're just going to put this in the fridge for 6 to 8 hours, maybe turn it every couple hours or so to make sure your eggs are fully mixed, and then pull them out and lay them out on newspaper or good clean paper of some sort and let them dry out. And about 4 or 5 hours of drying should do it. If you're having trouble getting them dry, put a little fan on them, and they'll be dry in no time and ready to fish. Now let's go back and catch some more salmon.
We're Hover Fishing Row in the Columbia River Gorge, a place where you can typically count on lots of salmon, but also lots of wind.
One of the challenges of fishing up here in the gorge is the wind. And when you're out here and you get no matter which way the wind's blowing, you have to adjust with your kicker blade. And like right now, the wind's coming from the west. So we got the boat backing down, and we got the motor in reverse. And what you're trying to shoot for is you want to keep the lines perfectly perpendicular. That way there's no
your baits, you know what level in the water column they're at, and it just keeps everything fishing correctly. As soon as you start getting your lines out at an angle, it's bringing your stuff off the bottom and you're out of the strike zone. So it's very important to keep fishing upright.
Under the boat.
Way to go, George.
Basically, when you feel feel them bite, just yank it home. They hit it pretty light half the time.
Thanks for watching today's episode. You know, without the support of the sponsors, the show would not be possible. So please thank them when you can. Now get out there and do some great fishing.